I'm Richard Coulter, head of marketing for the Fujitsu Network business, and I'm here with Greg Manganello, our head of network software and integration business unit. Greg came in to talk to us today about how AI-enabled applications are changing how networks are operated and how they're monetized. Thanks, Greg, for coming in and talking to us today about this really important and timely topic.
Glad to be here, Rich.
All right, so AI, like I mentioned, is a huge focus for the telecom industry. You can't go to a trade show, listen to a speech, pretty much go anywhere without hearing about AI and how it's going to change everything. So we're at this big part of the hype scale. And really wanted to hear from you, what compelling real-world use cases are you hearing for AI, and what is your team working on?
That's a great question, and you're right. I mean, AI is everywhere. You can't escape it. Even in the evening news, I think it's there. AI for MNOs are really about, you know, how can I simplify my operations, save money, and still have a high quality experience for my users. So in response to that, we've launched Fujitsu Virtura Intelligent Application. It's an AI-driven software portfolio to really help customers like save money and simplify ops.
Yeah, that's really interesting. So Virtura Intelligent Application, so it's a platform that's helping everybody take AI and apply it to telecom use cases.
That's
so are
right.
there specific use cases that you guys are using that for and helping to simplify the network?
Yeah, one of them that we're really excited about is our energy savings app for RUs and ORAN. And so it uses sort of a network-wide approach to save energy. And we all know that energy is 70% consumed by RUs.
Yeah.
And so our energy app has actually been proven in like head-to-head with competitors 20% more effective because we take sort of a network overall and AI-driven approach to do that.
Yeah, that's really interesting. That network-wide is really an interesting look. It's almost like Waze for the network. Now you're looking across the entire network rather than just the light that you can see ahead of you. So are there other applications or other use cases you're seeing for intelligent applications in the network?
Yeah, what we really notice is, especially as networks are getting more complex and now disaggregated with open RAN, open networks, is that trying to diagnose an alarm, it could be really tricky. And there's like these alarm storms that aren't just like one or two when there's a network trouble, but there can be like 1,000 in a minute. And it's kind of an overwhelming situation for a network operator. And of course, we want to find the real root cause of what caused the original one, but there's a lot of ghost alarms and derivative alarms that all have to be thrown out. And so we really have an accelerated RCA product now using ML that really peers through all those alarms and finds the root cause in minutes.
Yeah, that must be a huge savings, and not just for finding the problem, but also saving time of techs going from one place to another and jumping in their cars and going someplace and figuring out they don't have the right piece to use and then it not being the right thing at all.
That's absolutely right. And the current state is it can take sometimes hours and days, and in some cases, hard ones, weeks to find the root cause. So we can do it in minutes, which is a vast savings.
Huge savings. And are we talking about a storm, once every 6 months or once every year? I mean, how frequent is this problem in the network?
Yeah, it really happens a lot more than we thought it did. So we did some testing with a tier one operator here in the U.S. And what we realized is, hundreds of thousands of network elements. And there was storms that are like peaked at, hundreds or thousands of alarms. And it happened several times a week. So it's not like a rare event, like this is once a quarter kind of thing. This is several times a week, sometimes once a day. So this is a real area that can be, improved for cost savings.
Yeah, it sounds like a real savings and probably an energy efficiency benefit too, because you don't have to send people to multiple sites to actually figure out where the problem is. So
that's exactly right.
That's a great use case. So you mentioned open networks, and one that immediately comes to mind is Open RAN. And one of the kind of big pieces of software in the Open RAN is the RIC, the RAN Intelligent Controllers. I hoped you could talk to me a little bit about the many benefits it'll bring to the radio access network.
Two RICs, there's the non-real-time RIC and the near-real-time RIC. Non-real-time RIC, those are for applications that aren't quite as time-sensitive, like policy management or traffic forecasting. And then the near-real-time RIC is kind of a more hardcore computational heavy. So something that's like dynamic resource allocation could be apps there. It really provides a portal to network operators to have more people put different applications across a multi-vendor network without understanding all the underlying details. So at Fujitsu, we've developed an SDK for developers that really can get access to our AI ML platform so that they don't have to put AI inside their app, but they can really access that and really make their improvements across the whole network.
Yeah, that's really delivering. It feels like it'll deliver on the promises of ORAN, which is driving more innovation and more accelerating innovation into the network. So that's really, really interesting. And it seems like that the potential for development of applications really seems like it could be unlimited. And are you seeing limits? Are you seeing other areas where that might become useful?
Another thing that we're working on I'd like to share with you is our network coach. And so we're really looking at Gen AI and then combining it with our network operations knowledge. After all, we have an onshore NOC here in Richardson, Texas, and decades of experience. And we see what network operations teams need. And so we're taking our Fujitsu research, Gen AI, and network operations knowledge and kind of synthesizing it into a network coach. And so specifically what it does is we're using LLM sort of as a chat GPT interface for network operations people, but we want it to operate on, you know, vestiges of the network, like log files and JIRA tickets and network data, but LLM can't find that multi-vendor, multi-domain link itself. So we're working with our Fujitsu research team on automatic knowledge extraction AI, sort of like a bridge AI into this different data lake element so that a network operations person can say, you know, here's terabytes of data. Is there a signature, failure signature in here that I should be worried about? And it can isolate it down to the port level.
Wow, that's really interesting. So do you see that more as a integration in a lab type use case or one that's in the field that goes in hand with accelerated root cause analysis?
Yeah, it's interesting because accelerated RCA that I mentioned earlier helps with alarm storms, which is really an activated network situation. But network coach can be really used for both, including networks that we're building or SIing together. And so then it can, you know, detail out and figure out where is the problem, you know, even before it's activated by the NOC.
Yeah, that's interesting. So we talked about how AI is just everywhere in the industry and everyone is talking about it. What do you see as a differentiator for Fujitsu? What do you think stands out for us and why people should come to us and talk to us about applications?
Yeah, I think a couple of things. One is our Fujitsu research team is really AI driven. So we're looking at their AI models and what they're inventing, and then we're bringing it into apps and into our products. Secondly, our network operations knowledge can really, what use cases are real world happening and how can we use that knowledge to assist. And then, you know, when we kind of bring that all together, that's really different than just like, hey, we can, you know, coders for hire. So we're really bringing out AI-driven applications to really bring, efficiency to network operators.
Yeah, it's really network expertise baked into those AI applications. And that's the interesting part of how all of this is working and what you just talk to us about is how this is going to help real network operators change their operations and help turn the network more into a monetization platform.
That's right. We want to be practical with our AI. So, you know, the hype cycle's interesting, but like, how can I use this now? And how will this help me grow our business? And so what we're looking at now is like, you know, our vision of zero touch operations, there's kind of a milestone for like light touch operations. And so, but what we know about network ops people, since we have some, is they're a little bit on the control freak side. So they don't want AI making change to the network without their knowledge or approval. So what we have is now AI can say, we recommend these changes, bring it up to the network operator. And if they approve to say, every time we see this condition, can we do this? If it's yes, it kind of goes into the done bucket. And it's like AI-driven Kaizen, incremental changes every day, better and better. But at the end of a week, month, year, there's a whole stack of really AI-driven solutions to make the network self-healing.
Yeah, that's amazing. So slowly getting more and more towards automated network operations, zero-touch operations, or wherever that endpoint is that you want to get.
That's right. Well, you know, one approval at a time, so you know exactly what's happening and what you're getting. So no mysteries here.
Yeah, really, really interesting work from your team, Greg. Thanks for coming in and talking to us about how AI is going to help us automate the network and slowly build a Kaizen towards zero-touch operations.
Thanks, Rich. Thanks for having me.
Yeah.